Example 1. Don't date her, she's a theater major. Okay. Example number 2. You don't love me because you didn't wash the dishes or buy me that one thing or do that one thing or say that one thing. You don't love me because you didn't do the thing. Third example. You're an illustration major. Don't you want to eat after college? All of these statements that I've given are arguments. There's a conclusion at the end, or at the beginning, in the case of the first two, and there's a supporting statement. The thing that's interesting about these ones is that the supporting statement by itself is not enough to make any sense with the conclusion. Let's look at the first one. Don't date her, she's a theater major. In this case, don't date her is the conclusion. Like, this is the thing you shouldn't do. And then the statement that he gives to back that up is, she's a theater major. What does that have to do with anything? Unless you assume something. This is called an enthymeme, and it's extremely common in the way that we interact with people on a day-to-day basis. This type of argument has an unspoken, required premise in order to get the first part to work. So, don't date her, she's a theater major, says something about theater majors. It says that theater majors are people that you should not date. This is the unspoken statement here. And that may or may not be true. You could attack that and look at that and say, well, I know so-and-so, and they're a theater major, and they're date-worthy material. Enthymemes aren't necessarily good or bad, but if you find a weak place in an argument, it's frequently going to be the enthymeme, and it's extremely helpful to be aware that there is an unspoken premise, and that just because it's unspoken doesn't mean it can't be questioned. Statement 2. You don't love me because you didn't do the thing. In this case, they're telling you something about their definition of love. So you don't love me is the conclusion, right here. You don't love me. And then the supporting statement is you didn't do this. So there's an assumption here that if you loved me, you would have done this thing. They're telling you about the definition of love and telling you a little bit about their love language, if you're into that sort of thing. Again, just because it's unstated doesn't mean it can't be questioned. And it means you probably should question it and address it and say, so if I don't do the dishes, then I don't love you? Is this what you're saying? And then make it explicit and talk about it and work it back and forth. Yeah, relationship advice. Good stuff. Don't blame me for anything. Third one. You're an illustration major. Don't you want to eat after college? In this case, there's actually a couple of premises that are hidden here. There's one about the purpose of college. It is essentially that the reason one goes to college and gets these things is to get a career and to get a job. And that may or may not be true. Again, it's unspoken. That doesn't mean it can't be questioned. In this case, maybe that's not why you're going to college. Maybe you're going purely for the educational experience. But maybe you are going for a job. The second one is, with an illustration major, you can't get a job. So there's a specific thing about college and majors, and there's a specific thing about this particular major. And in this case, there are two unspoken premises, both of which, though they are unspoken, still deserve to be questioned. This is the nutshell about enthymemes. Pay attention for them, look for them. If you think of any other awesome examples, be sure to comment below. Be sure to give us a thumbs up and also to subscribe. Enjoy.